rear of the motor housing on the starter is a single stud. The motor has dual studs. On the rear here is a small plate that covers the bearing on the rear. In there you find a washer and a nut on the rear end of the rotor. The rest you can see where the brushes are located inside the cover. So inside the rotor housing, you can see the brushes. There's normally springs that hold those in. Here's the band. It covers up the openings for the brushes and the individual brush springs. The rotor. Brushes are contacting. Here are the two washers that sandwich the bearing at the end and the castle nut within the end of the housing. The other end has a gear that's attached to it with a screw. This protrudes through into the next housing, the rear housing, and has to be removed to take the housings and split them. Here's the gear. It mates with the crown gear inside the next housing. It aligns in here. It's keyed and then has a screw with a keeper that folds up against it. The motor shaft protrudes through this housing, and on this opposite side is where that previous gear sits. It then mates with this crown gear, which fits into that large bearing, like that. With the crown gear removed, on the back side, you can see the pressed in bearing. Beyond that is another cap. Inside of that cap is a smaller bearing. That bearing supports subshaft fits through the crown gear. And provides a pivot support for the planetary gears. Here are the planetary gears. Those mesh with the end of the crown gear, and attached to them is a clutch mechanism. And on the end of that is the throw out that twists out the engaging jaw. Engaging jaw is here, attaches down in there, and it comes out to engage with the engine. Planetary gears are held inside of this housing, this extension. You can see there's a brass insert with the outer planetary gear. It goes around the outside and engages down with the planetary gears. It's able to turn like that. This cover contains a leather seal, the washer on the back. It's very important that you do not attempt to remove that leather seal. It's press fit in there with these little pin holes. They hold a retainer in the back and it's press fit in there. This goes over the top here, seals around the back of the jaw. Around the outside of that are individual spring compression pieces. And around those are the compression spring. Here are the major components, how they mount together. This piece here mounts onto the motor, like so. And the piece that contains the planetary gears mounts here. And then on top of that, the extension. Similar piece of equipment is an Eclipse hand crank starter. are similar. It's the hand crank